Ibiza TV and Newcastle United. Latest news, are going to get a $260 billion takeover. $260 billion. To put that in perspective, if you think it's not a big thing, the second place is Manchester City, which is $23 billion. $260 billion is technically the worth of every single Premier League team owner, every single Champions League owner, every single League 1, League 2, every single goddamn owner in the English football tier combined won't have $260 billion. But yes, it's going to be a $260 billion takeover in which 10% is settled to 1%, 10% to the other person, and 80% to the main Saudi fund group, which, to tell you the truth, is going to be scary and hilarious at the bottom. Hilarious because Newcastle United are being brought, and scary because you know what money can do. It's a very big thing, and it's going to be very, very, very shocking. So, speaking wise, as a City fan, I'm not so scared because, as you know, it... just because you are bought by which team, I mean which owner, doesn't mean you're going to be like, you know, the number one team in the world directly. But yes, it does mean that Newcastle United can build up extensively and easily. They can buy literally every single player. The transfer market fees don't even exist now for them. They can just take a check, just shove it off the money, and you know, the deal done. And speaking wise, that is the most scariest part about this deal which is happening. Now, all of us know that Newcastle United have been going through some tough time. Mark Ashley is one of the worst owners according to them. And I believe that, yes, the ownership should change. But the club is at $300 million selling it. And if this deal happens, what are we going to expect? Well, according to me, if you give me, it would take at least 2 to 3 years for, you know, Newcastle to actually get the good players in. And this first start by just as Man City, just firing off the check money, buying whatever players they can get their hands into. But I don't expect any of the best players coming in directly. But yes, they will be the good players who are going to come in. And that is going to make a definite difference for the league. Now, if you just to tell you, second place is Man City, third place is Chelsea by 10 billion. Just 10. So, if the second and third place is 23 billion, followed by fourth is Arsenal, which another 7, which is 40. You can just see with this now how much it means. So, that is what I'm saying. If this deal actually happens, we are all going to lose it. Seriously. Newcastle won't be a threat now, but after 5 to 6 or maybe even 7 years, they will be winning all the trophies. It will not be Big 6 anymore. It will be a Big 7, or if one of the top teams like Tottenham are just considered, no trophy, no team, not a big in the top 6, knocked off. That would be the issue. So the deal is becoming very close, but if it actually happens, it's going to... which it looks quite likely, it is going to be a challenging thing. The game of football will be now money driven, like everything will be money. There's going to be nothing known as loyalty. And my predictions are, the minute the takeover happens, the next season, Bruce, who is now currently the manager, will be sacked. They'll get someone else who's experienced and wanting the money. And they'll start buying many players, but you know, the players like Sancho, Mbappe and all of these will happen. They will happen definitely, but not right now. Definitely maybe in a 4 or 7 or 8 years when, you know, Newcastle start getting the trophies in. That is when this is going to happen. So if it happens, yes, it happens. And if not, we are lucky to survive one of the biggest disasters apart from what is going now. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, to like, share, subscribe. Almost going to touch 1,000 subscribers soon. So please help me to reach that number soon. Take care, stay safe, wash your hands. Goodbye.